everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Early season, mid-season, late season, it really doesn't matter. The SEC doesn't wait to turn up the intensity. An early season matchup in the Southeastern Conference. That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football pregame show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
Stadium in Tallahassee, proud home of the Florida State Seminoles since 1950. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. See how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. Number 82, deep turn. He's to the 20. Across the 30. He's taken down at the 34-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Down around the 29-yard line. So they pick up big yards on the option keeper.
I thought he's going to break that one for a touchdown. You couldn't draw that up any better.
So we've got a first down after a great running play. He fights forward to about the 26.
Second and seven.
Hey, long day for you.
Hey, Mike 51.
Let's go!
And he scores! Touchdown!
That did more than just put 6 points on the board. It takes a lot of pressure off the offensive coordinator when the man under center can show that he's a dual threat.
The extra point. Chase is the kind of impact player that every team in the country would love to have on their team. And we've seen some early film on him. Kirk and I, you know, we looked at it. He looks legit, but we'll see if it translates to real competition. Florida State is lining up to kick this one off. Butler from the six. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Tackle made at about the 29-yard line. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on their own 29. He's to the 40, and he's tackled right around the 44-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 15 yards. First down.
Here we go. Tight right.
Let's go. fires to his receiver. First down.
Guys, I really like what the offensive coordinator is doing here. Throwing it on first and second down will keep the defense guessing.
First and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. And they push him out at the 39. Some open field, and he tackles him hard at the 29-yard line.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
From the 29-yard line, it's first down. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set.
Well, we get a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche?
Run left side, and they hit him in the backfield. Third down, and they need to get it to the 19. There's a strike complete. He's down. Flanagan picks up 6 yards with that grab. Tight end on the line here on fourth and short. Fires incomplete, knocked away.
I'm not going to fault that decision. It was definitely a first down that they could have picked up. You want to be aggressive early on, even if it doesn't always work out.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. Florida State is up by a touchdown. He fights forward to about the 20. It's 2nd and 9. Ball on the 20. Side run there.
Third down.
Gets it out to his receiver and he can't hang on.
Let's see if the momentum from that defensive stand carries over to their offense.
Williams is the punter. And he can't hang on to the ball. Brought down at the 49.
I'll tell you, a few plays in football can test your concentration like returning punts. You got to see the ball into your hands while not worrying about being hit.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Mullins gains about 5 yards on the run.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
From the 46-yard line, it's 2nd down.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
He's tackled at the 37.
Besides going deep on the fade, the slant route is probably the most commonly run route against man coverage. If the receiver gets a good inside release, it'll be a new set of downs every time.
Looks like we're going to have a good game on our hands after one. The Seminoles with a touchdown lead. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. That's a loss of 4 yards.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
From the 41-yard line, it's second down. Makes it out to about the 30. Right around the 28-yard line. So they're going to go for it here. You don't need three guesses to figure out what they're going to run right here on fourth and short. Sweep left. Tackle around the 20-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. They'll bring him down around the 11-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. This offense has really stalled on their last two trips to the red zone. And he's taken down around the 8-yard line.
That makes it
first down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. They make the stop at about the 5-yard line. Here's the 11th play of the drive. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
Time to get you up to date on some scores from around the country. Back and forth these two teams go, neither one giving an inch. We could be headed to a photo finish. UTEP out front, 10-7.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Motley takes it from the 6. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. He tackles him for a loss.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 28.
Let's go!
He's to the 40. He's at midfield. He's taken down at the 47. gets out to around the 35. From the 35-yard line, first down. He's on the run. That's a great tackle at the 27-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
The Seminoles will use their first time out of the half.
Hey, let's get that ball, D. Let's get that ball. 51, Mike. Mike 51. Set. Hot.
Got a man. Watch out here. Brought down at the 21-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 21. Scrambling around. Tackle made around the 21-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Ready? Mike 51. Mike 51.
And he throws it away. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And he's tackled at about the 11. On third and long, they get the first down, but was it close?
Close or not, what a relief it is to the quarterback to have a new set of downs to work with.
First and 10. Ball on the 11-yard line. He's tackled at the 2-yard line. Tries to buy some time. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
And he tacks on the extra point. Let's get the latest now from Reese David.
The Ponies ready to tee it up as SMU is set to go in University Park. This one's been entertaining us all day long. And for SMU, they could drop their fourth in a row. The Miners are on top, 17-14.
All right, Reese, back to our game. Florida State, they kick this one off. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off.
How did he drop that? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? He drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Quick throw, incomplete, blocked his receiver.
Can't blame him for not hanging on to that pass. He got hit pretty hard.
From their own 25-yard line, third down.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. It's a short kick. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Florida State is up a score. And he stops the
the clock with a spike.
So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. The kick is up, and it is good. I have a feeling this ball is going nowhere near the return man. Kickoff, most likely to end the half.
He's to the 20.
That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. We played a half of football. Florida State leads 17-7.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Both of these defenses are opportunistic and very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively, how about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, did a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Butler from the six. He's out to the 30. Knocked out of bounds at the 33. Florida State's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Gets it out quickly. And a huge touchdown play. Here's the point after to try to cut this to a three-point game. He makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Florida State has a three-point lead.
Oklahoma!
And he hits him hard at the 40-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line.
The option is all about timing, and on that play, the timing was just off. That's going to happen sometimes.
It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 38. No, he dropped it.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
Williams to punt. Tackle at the 32-yard line. Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
Makes it out to about the 40.
That's a deep. That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Muhammad goes with a play fake. Throws to the tight end, and that ball's incomplete. At the 45-yard line.
Gaining five on the play. First down.
From their own 45-yard line, it's first down.
Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Gains his way to the 46-yard line.
That's a deep.
Not over here.
That brings up second and one.
Hit before it can go anywhere.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. First down.
From the 41-yard line. First down.
Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and five.
Steps up and goes down. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. And they'd at least like to have some yardage here and give their kicker a chance to tie this game. Quick pass, tackle at about the 33-yard line. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Florida State is up by 3. Tackled after a decent pickup. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Bring him down behind the line. They don't get back to the line of scrimmage there on the option keeper, a loss of one. Gets out to about the 44-yard line.
I'll tell you what, he's pretty nimble for a big guy. Excellent display of athletic ability.
From their own 44-yard line, first down. the middle for a nice game. And folks, it's neck and neck as we head to the final quarter of play. 17-14, FSU. Game in the fourth quarter. And a good play there.
Here they give it to the fullback on the option, and the big guy gets good yardage.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 44. Florida State holds a field goal lead. Knocked out of bounds around the 31-yard line.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
And they make the stop at the 34.
The offense knows that the linebackers are cheating up a little bit on the run. They can get some protection. They might want to open up a little bit of space for some passes underneath.
From the 34-yard line, it's second down. And he's taken down at the 25.
That's good for D&D. Third down.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
Number 82 was the intended receiver on the play.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They'll bring him down at the 20.
Oh, that was a big conversion. You could just see the other team's offense itching to get back on the field.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. To his receiver. He's taken down at the 8. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Florida State is up a field goal. Coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
And he hits the PAT. So a 12 play, 80 yard drive, and the result, 7 points. Hefner ready to kick. He's to the 20. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. The Seminoles defense came to play, and man, they have played beautifully.
How many do they have dressed out there? 12 or 13 defenders? I mean, they're flying all over the field, and this poor offense just can't move the ball. They have no chance.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Pass is caught. The defense lays him out.
Second and 5.
Ball on the 31-yard line.
Let's go.
caught, and this is going to be a first down. 8-yard gain on the pass. That'll be good enough for the first down.
Great look from the quarterback to find his receiver and make the quick throw for the new set of downs.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. Quick strike to the receiver. And they push him out at the 50-yard line. First down. Tackled at the 36-yard line.
That's a smart play here by the quarterback. He threw it into the window the zone coverage gave him. Nice pass and a nice job by the receiver running the slant.
Second and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Flares it and almost had it intercepted. This is the eighth play of this drive. So they're going to go for it here. Just under two to go in the game. He's pushed out of bounds at the 30. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He tackles him hard at the 32. He plows ahead for a 2-yard gain. Alabama is going to use their first time out of the half here. From their own 32-yard line. Second down. Nice run up the middle. Alabama will take their second time out of the half. At the 36.
He was never able to get ahead of carry.
Alabama's called their final timeout. Henry is back deep to return the punt. He makes it to the 38-yard line. Time's becoming a factor now as the offense takes over after the punt.
Well, the clock is not on their side right now. They just need to hope that they can get a very quick score here, then hope for the best.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again.
I'm really liking what I see from this guy. He's not afraid to go to the air on any down.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Gets it. He's in space. Dives for extra yardage. A little over a minute in the game. Throws and it's incomplete. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 27. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
first down.
That's a great tackle at the 4-yard line.
That's a gain of 10 on the play.
Check, check.
That makes it first and
goal. Thunder! Thunder! Ready! Right, 80!
The spike will stop the clock.
That brings in second and goal.
Here's the eighth play of the series.
Let it go, and it's caught for the touchdown.
Late in the fourth quarter, one possession game, and this is where poise really takes over. Whoever shows it will win the football game.
Here's the extra point to get within a field goal. He splits the uprights with the extra point. It was a 7-play, 62-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
Whoa, he just took a licking.
Here we are late in the fourth quarter, and this is what this game has come down to. Every possession is going to count, and this could be the one right here.
We have less than a minute to go.
Takes a knee.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. Favorite play in football of your quarterback. Take a knee. So this one goes final. A hard-fought, close game. 24-21, Seminole. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.